Hi, 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 hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Now we will continue our discussion on Telangana State Assistant Engineer Electrical 2015 solutions. So the first question is, which portion of the power system is least prone to fault? So in all the four options, the switch gear and transformers and overhead transmission lines are exposed to atmosphere. That is such as lightning arrest, lightning surges and thunder strokes. So the alternator is a part which is less prone to the faults. So alternator is the option here. Next one. In the solution of load flow equation, the Newton Raphson method is superior to the Gauss Seidel method because the convergence criteria of the Newton Raphson method are not affected by selection of slack bus. So this is the answer. The standard question. Next one. So here a voltage source inverter will have better performance if it is. So voltage source inverter will have two inductances. One is called source inductance, second one is called load inductance. Okay. So for an inverter, the load inductance should be more and the source inductance should be less. Otherwise, what will happen is when you are operating the inverter switches, so because of the source inductance, the one phase leg SCRs are conducting simultaneously so that the SCR may get the SCR short circuit the supply voltage VS. So this is the reason why to avoid the shoot through effect, the load inductor should be large and the source inductor should be very small. Next question here is, a three phase wound rotor induction motor is controlled by chopper control resistance in a rotor circuit. The resistance of 2 ohms is connected in the rotor circuit and the resistance of 4 ohms is additionally connected during off periods of the chopper. The off period of the chopper is 4 milliseconds. So T off is nothing but 4 milliseconds and T on is nothing but 1 by 200 hertz is given in the given problem. Then we will find our average resistance is a question mark. So we can find T on plus T off is equal to T. So from this relationship, if we substitute T on is equal to, so 1 by 200 minus 4 milliseconds is nothing but, we'll get 1 milliseconds as the answer. So 5 milliseconds minus 4 milliseconds is equal to 1 millisecond as the answer. So our average is equal to, so T on during onset resistance is R on plus T off and the resistance during off state is R off divided by total time period. So this is nothing but T on is how much? 2. R on, sorry, T on is how much? 1 milliseconds. R on is 1 plus T off is how much? It is nothing but, so 4 milliseconds. So 4 into, what is the resistance during the period? So it is nothing but 2 plus 4, 6 divided by T is nothing but, I will multiply with 200 here because total frequency is 200. So if we solve this, we will get 26 by 5 ohms as the answer. So option is 1 is the right option. Next one, the main function of economizer of a boiler in a plant is to reduce the fuel consumption to heat to convert the water into steam. So it uses the flue gases from the boiler. So flue gases to convert the water into steam. So reduce the fuel consumption for making the water into steam. Next question. A chopper is fed from a constant voltage mains. The duty ratio of the chopper is progressively increased while the chopper feeds RL load. So per unit current ripple would be, so this is the graph I got from the PSBMR textbook, so which says that the per unit ripple current as a function of T on by TA. So this is a per unit current ripple increase in X axis and the ripple per unit ripple current in Y axis here. You know, as the time period increases, the ripple content increases linearly up like this up to this point. After then it is reaches to a maximum value. After then it decreases like this. So in the given options, increases to a maximum value at alpha equal to 0.5 here and then starts decreasing. So option is 4. Now the Boolean expression y is equal to y of ABC is equal to a plus BC is to be realized using two input gates only, one type. So is it maybe NAND gate or not, what it may be. So minimum number of gates required. So I will take a NAND gate here. So NAND gate means, so this NAND gate, and I will take another NAND gate. So I will give the input for the NAND gate 1 as A, so that I will get A bar here and BC here. So BC bar I got here. So if I give the same input to another AND gate, so we'll get A plus BC. So what is the minimum number of gates required for realization is 1, 2, 3. So answer is 3. The output F for the 4 to 1 multiplexer is shown in the figure. So we need to find the output here. So output F is equal to, we can write it as X bar, Y bar. The selection pins are X, Y here. So first one is ground 0 plus X bar, Y. And second one, 1, 2, 3 are connected to 1, logic 1 plus X, Y bar, logic 1 plus X, Y into 1. So from this term is 0. So we can write is X bar, Y plus X, Y bar plus X, Y. Additionally, we will take X, Y again here. So that by simplifying this, what we will get here is, we can write this one as X. So we make a common here. So X plus X bar into Y here plus Y into X plus. Sorry, here mistaken. So here it is nothing but X into Y plus Y bar. So that will get X plus Y here. So important to be considered here is, so X bar, Y bar into 0 here. If you are taking the reverse means, you will get wrong answer. So this is a 2 is the right option, X plus Y. And for an N-channel MOSFET and its transfer curve, as shown in the figure, the threshold voltage is, you can say that here, it's a 1 volt here. So it is 1 volt. So threshold voltage is 1 volt. But we cannot say that when the MOSFET is in active region or in saturation, because the threshold voltage is 1 volt. So if it is greater than 1 volt means we can say that the saturation, it is entered to saturation region. Less than 1 means it is in active region, cutoff region. So threshold 1 means it may be in, so 1 volt, the device is in active region. So minus 1 volt, the device is in saturation region. So 1 and 3 are the right answers. Okay, and next one, last one. The common mode rejection ratio of a differential gain amplifier AD, AD gain, AD is differential gain and AC is common gain. So this is the CMRR is equal to, RR is equal to 20, not sorry, it's a 10 only. Well, because we are taking powers. So 10 log base 10 of AD by AC. Well, because they are powers. Suppose these are voltage means we can take 20 log. So here if it's a 10 log means it's the answer is correct, this one, but it's a 20. So this is the wrong one. And you can say that 10 log 10 means is nothing but 1. So 1 into AD by AC is the answer. So 48th one is answer. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching my videos. Have a nice day.